Charlie Kirk. Yep. Charlie Kirk thinks Democrats are creating variations of the COVID virus in order to win the midterm elections. Here it is.
But something that I'm cautioning grassroots Americans about, and something that I want to continue to reiterate, is the Democrats have something up their sleeve. This new variant, BA.5, whatever this is, they say that there's going to be new mask mandates, vaccine mandates, and potentially increased mail-in voting.
Yeah.
So we have to be vigilant. It's not a sure thing that we're going to wipe them out in November yet. I sure hope that's the case. I think the American people are there. But the Democrats, it's out of pure and total respect for how evil and terrible they are. I think they have something else planned.
All right, Charlie, you don't look well, buddy. Okay, look like you've fallen off. Now, I'm just telling you this because I care enough to let you know this on my show. Let's go through the details, because when I saw this, I said, what the hell? Literally, Charlie Kirk is saying that Democrats are creating the variant, right, of COVID. They are strategic enough to create a COVID variant in order to propel an atmosphere forward that would give them a better outcome in the midterm elections. All right. Democrats can barely organize a voter registration drive. Charlie Kirk is pushing this narrative, and you have to question, where in the hell did Charlie get this from? Because remember, he's not a real independent thinker. Everything he says, he grabbed from somebody. So let's put it up, okay? See that guy? His name is Wayne Allen Root, a conservative radio host, a far-right political commentator, and noted conspiracy theorist. Published Sunday, Root wrote a piece entitled, "The Democratic Plan to Steal Midterms, Say Goodbye to Biden and Hello to King Kong Monkey COVID-19. That was Charlie Kirk's muse, his inspiration. In it, he said, and I quote, "Remember, Democrats never let a crisis go to waste, whether it's a new scarier variant of coronavirus, a monkey coronavirus, King Kong COVID-19, polio, Marburg virus. Democrats and their PR wing, the mainstream media, will soon be inundating you with scary news to make you hysterical. Hide in your home for months, mask up, and get your 25th vaccine." I mean, it's full of hyperbole and misinformation, right? But Charlie Kirk adopted this for his show. BA.5 is not new. This sister variant of Omicron was actually first identified in January. It has been tracked since April. BA.5, part of the Omicron family, is the latest coronavirus variant to cause widespread waves of infection globally. Documented fact. According to the World Health Organization's most recent report, it was behind 52% of cases sequenced in late June, up from 37% in 1 week. In the United States, it is estimated to be causing around 65% of current infections. As a current vaccine or current vaccines continue to protect those who are in fact vaccinated, the tweaking of the vaccines provides more protection. So bottom line, if you're vaccinated and you got a booster, you're likely not going to have severe symptoms and you're not going to die, all right, virtually. There is no evidence that BA.5 is more dangerous than any of the other Omicron variants. All those spikes in cases can put health services under pressure and risk more people getting long COVID, all right? The WHO and other experts have said the ongoing pandemic, prolonged by vaccine inequity and the desire for many countries to move beyond COVID-19, would in fact lead to new and unpredictable variants. They said this from day one. The fact that you have significant inequity in healthcare and you have this massive virus across the planet, you're going to see significant variations of the virus. They said that on day one. They were right. That's exactly what we've seen. Charlie Kirk believes Democrats are somehow creating variants of COVID. to win a midterm election. Thoughts on this and old Charlie Kirk.
I wish the Democrats were half as effective and strategic and progressive as the right says that they are. He really believes that they developed a variant. You're exactly right. The Dems wouldn't even need to develop a variant because so many people didn't get vaccinated and so many people didn't get access to the care that they needed that the virus has been able to mutate in the extreme in the United States, especially because we have such low herd immunity here. But I wouldn't be getting scientific commentary from Charlie Kirk, the same guy who said he believes a dolphin fetus is a human being. And I also want to point out that he calls everyday working Americans grassroots Americans. He talks about them in terms of how many votes you can get from them, right? Grassroots is a political term. These are just everyday Americans, but he chooses this language because he's thinking about winning elections. And he brings this to COVID mail-ins. And he's already making right-wing voters, again, like they did in 2020, fearful and hateful of mail-in voting. And then when the ballots are cast, they start questioning, why did so few of our Republican voters cast mail-in ballots? Why are these all for Democrats? It's because you made your base hate mail-in voting. And so they're just, you know, creating conspiracies to foment support for election fraud. When it happens, they're planting seeds of doubt that they're gonna start sowing as soon as votes start coming in.
It's really interesting that the main thing for Charlie Kirk and his cronies is to invalidate absentee voting or additional access to, let's say, drop box locations, et cetera. In the state of Georgia, Donald Trump actually won on the machines. A lot of people don't know this. While they went around saying the machines are rigged, well, he actually won on the machines. The machines in Georgia showed Donald Trump won the election. It was the absentee ballots that they counted that were legally submitted votes is when Donald Trump lost the election. But those are legal votes. Those are citizens exercising their rights.